just finished cleaning the fuel injectors to the sublight drive. You should notice a 0.00008% power increase.
Yeah. Tell me why you're so concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The time is upon you. I am here. Say your piece.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
You are my master's sworn enemy.
Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
My quarrel is with you, Jedi. These men need not suffer.
Your temperance is remarkable. Hiroshio, please leave with your men immediately.
Thank you. Thank you, Master Carr. And you as well, Sith.
Get out of here.
Now that they're safe, I'll speak plainly. I know Barriss has spies, and I know you were sent to extract two of them before they could be exposed. But I'll soon have the proof I need. Barriss's spies can't hide for long.
There's no proof to get, Carr. You're deluded.
Don't waste your breath with lies. Forgive the earlier deception, Sith. But now that Orosho and his men have escaped harm, I must neutralize you immediately. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
You're digging your own grave.
And you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in, by any means necessary. Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
I'll wait right here, Carr. Come and face me now.
Jedi do not seek out a fight until we meet again.
Here. Stand by for examination and suggested products. Report your ailments. Stand by for examination and suggested products. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
I doubt that Jedi will let her out of his sight.
You may be right, but as you close in on his prized pupil, he will be forced to deal with us. I am confident this is how we will prevail. The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish you cause will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
As you decree, my lord.
This will be a great test for you, apprentice. You have yet to face a Jedi Master. The righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating. And Noman Carr is no ordinary master. Confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
It will be an interesting experience.
Be sure your results are of interest to me. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her.
I'm done talking to you. Take the collar off or go away.
Do you enjoy this as much as I do?
Doesn't even hurt anymore. You want it to be like this? Fine. Just don't expect one word of help beyond what I have to do.
Touchdown on Alderaan, the home planet of Noman Carr's Padawan, where he claimed her for the Jedi. Good, good. You will discover everything you can about this Padawan, and destroy everyone she loves there.
It is a certainty.
I hope your results will confirm your confidence. Unfortunately, with the civil war for the Alderaanian throne raging, your contact, Duke Kendo of House Thule, has become unreliable. Kendo was to discover more about the Padawan, her name, loved ones, but he's distracted. You must realign his priorities.
Why don't I just kill him?
No doubt someday the man's usefulness will be exhausted, but today is not that day. Kendo is a political creature. The consequences of failing me are abstract for him. Once they are made concrete, he'll cooperate. You'll find him in the House Thule executive chambers. Make haste.
Greetings, my lord. I bring the good wishes of Moff Sarek, the officer entrusted with annexing this planet. He has been anticipating your arrival.
It is fitting that we speak.
A good day, my lord. It will well serve the aims of the Empire to have so accomplished a Sith on this planet. I expect to care little for the niceties of politics here, so I will be brief. The Empire intends to use Alderaan's succession struggle to bring it into the fold, and I'm offering you the opportunity to play a pivotal role.
What's the situation here?
The heir to Alderaan's throne was recently assassinated, right after withdrawing from the protection of the Republic. The planet's in civil war, and for the first time in thousands of years, without the armies of the Republic to bring order.
A divided world will fall quickly.
Yes. We must make our move now, while the throne stands empty. We have an alliance with one of the noble houses, House Thule. The house was exiled 60 years ago after a failed bid for power and came to us instead. Unfortunately, they have proven too weak to do what's needed.
Do they need the fear of the Emperor put into them?
Yes. Jorad, one of the Thule lords, insists on following Alderaan's rules of civilized warfare. I want you to show him warfare is far from civil. Several of Thule's vassal houses have rebelled since Thule's connection to us became public. This cannot be allowed. Take a slave collar from my man here and drag one of these rebels to our weak-willed Lord Thule. Kill the rest and leave them where they fall.
They will learn that the best way to survive is to submit.
These lords of Alderaan must lose their foolish pride. Those who will not bow must break.
Imagine leaving your home for a sojourn into the galaxy. When you return, you find the manor infested. The wood is rotten and wriggling. Beetles carpet floors you raced across as a child. And maggots drop in tangled clumps onto your head. With due respect, my lord, this is what House Thule faces. An infestation of vermin.
The Sith return from exile to a galaxy overrun with Jedi.
Then you understand, though our infestation is of a more literal kind. The Killix are Alderaan's native insectoid population. Man-sized, barely intelligent. It's the nobility's duty to contain the swarms underground. Unchecked, they are ravaging this planet, turning palaces into hives and cocooning the survivors. Generations caught in the mandibles of beasts.
You said they're native to this world. They were here first?
Legend has it, Killix once ruled the planet. Supposedly most flew to the stars. But how many remained in hibernation? House Organa has been neglecting their responsibilities against the vermin. But even they carry defenses against Killix hunting parties. If you could seize the Organa toxins and poison the Killix hives, well, the Killix will swarm, and the other houses must defend themselves and do their part.
That seems a wise idea.
We will all war against the Killix, and Thule will save this planet from infestation.
No Jedi will be able to stand against you. Is a lie.
Crymar? Is that Crymar Novan? That's a free nobleman of Alderaan. Unhand him. Who are you? What's this about? Ow!
If you are to join the Empire, you should take more care to recognize those in power.
My lord.
All of Alderaan will be thrown into chains because of you.
Silence, slave. The sooner you see reason, the easier it will be.
I've said before that being too harsh might stir greater rebellion. Though, of course, that's up to you.
I believe that is up to me.
Sir.
This spineless toad will make a poor lord of Alderaan.
Yes. It will take work to shape him. I hope you will undertake this for me. I would like to make you the voice of the Empire in House Thol. Aid Jorad and his men in crushing resistance to our rule. Obey him as if it were me, and with the same penalty for defiance. Tell him what you need, and he will ensure Thul's hold on Alderaan.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Penalty for defiance. I like the sound of that.
I suppose the Morph expects us to take on House Organa. They're one of our oldest noble houses, and loyal to the Republic. Until recently, they've been without an army, but they've got supporters all over the planet. Including here.
You'll never find them. They've got top-of-the-line cloaking, better than anything the Empire makes. No probes will get through, no spy sats, nothing.
You are an imbecile.
House Organa denied raising an army, claiming it's just patriots defending their lands. But their attacks are too organized. We'll never find every group. We need to get inside their planet-wide communications. And that means finding a base with a physical link to slice into.
Just tell me where to go.
The Organa guerrillas have a base hidden in some cave or other natural camouflage. There should be a master comm link there, guarded by their best soldiers. If you insert this computer spike, it'll give us a back door into all their communications.
If we slice into their command center, we can avoid falling into any traps.
House Organa will not make another move without us knowing.
You lack patience, Duke Kendo. There are standard procedures that must be adhered to.
Your disregard for our family rules is appalling. You are an abomination. Goodbye, cousin.
Fools. They won't be feeling much of anything for long.
Duke Kendo, Darth Barriss sent me.
What? You're not on my schedule. I don't appreciate being interrupted. Barriss isn't even on my radar, Sith. I have a war to wage and personal ambitions to achieve here.
Aiding Barriss may help you achieve those ambitions.
Please, don't try to manipulate me. I have Sith bodyguards of my own now. Tell Barriss I'm through being his lackey. Femres, show this intruder out. On his feet or his back, makes no difference to me.
I'm sorry, Duke Kendo. We are assigned to protect you and support your interests in the struggle for Alderaan. But we serve the Emperor first, and we will not cross Darth Barriss, or his apprentice.
It's good to know some people have respect.
We consider you an ally, friend.
Okay. That was unexpected. It seems I may have been hasty regarding your master's needs. How can I make amends?
You can start by bowing to me, too.
Of course. Consider it a small demonstration of my repentance. I pledge the same level of focus that had me so absorbed in my own work. I pledge myself to your directives, and as I aid you, perhaps you'll be moved to help me in mine.
We'll see. Time will tell.
I am focused and at your service. As I recall, Darth Barriss wanted information on a young Alderaanian girl who was taken off-planet to train with Jedi Master Nomen Kar. I was to locate her family so that you could, well, send the girl a message.
For your sake, I hope you were successful.
The truth is, information about this girl is difficult to come by. I managed only one lead. Nomen Kar's Padawan fits the description of the former handmaiden of a noblewoman in House Alder named Lady Renata. I've questioned her already, but Renata is protected by House Alder's greatest champion. The man has never met his match in melee.
He's never met me.
If I may, once you've eliminated her protector and gotten what you need, I would personally be very indebted if you'd arrange to have Lady Renata brought to us for questioning.
I'll take it under consideration.
All right. I just hope the mood strikes you. While House Alder is a small player on Alderaan, it is affiliated with House Organa. Therefore, Lady Renata's estate is in hostile territory and very well defended. be cautious.
Caution is for worms like you.
I won't argue with you there. I do hope to see you soon. Until then...
Please select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Yeah.
Impressive work. You can see we now have access to the Organa systems. They're all talking about the ruthlessness and brutality of the recent attack. They do train you Imperials well, don't they?
Wars are not won by talking.
Oh, you're right. We're going to be trying for the throne. That's worth a little brutality. Now that we can monitor the Organa's communications, it should be possible to...
Lord Thule! The base is under attack!
Send aid quickly! Border Outpost 2 under attack! I repeat, under attack!
Perimeter defense is breached! We're under attack by assault droids! Repeat, a coordinated attack by probe and assault droids!
Blood of the Queen!
Sounds like you need a little Imperial support right now.
Yes. Show those backbiters that the Empire stands behind House Thule! The data says all three border posts are under attack. Looks like a coordinated effort. Hunter killers and probes. All I've got out there is a skeleton crew. You're the only one close enough to reach them in time. Please, save my bases and bring me the memory cores from any probes you destroy. I want to know who's behind this. Good luck.
I'll bring you the heads of those droids and their master.
Thank you. Now hurry!
Thank you. not win this day.
Killick hives have been poisoned. They'll swarm soon.
And the noble houses must accept their obligation to combat them, thanks to Thul leadership. In another life, you would have made a fine royal guardian of the mountains. I cannot thank you enough for your quick work. I don't know what the Organas were after, but that attack was long in the planning.
It was a costly defeat for them.
Well, they have deep pockets, but it won't be quick to rebuild such a force. Who's the source of these? What were they looking for? And quickly!
The programming signatures point to Lord Cedric Kilesa.
Lord Kilesa's my vassal. He swore loyalty to me personally when we returned from exile.
Your vassals have too much freedom. Slavery works better.
The parameters indicate the probes were to join an assault team in a... My lord, this program indicates an assault team massing in a tunnel between here and the Kilesa estate. I don't find any such tunnel on the blueprint.
The siege tunnel! Blood of a queen! They're coming through the siege tunnel!
Those attacks were meant to draw your guards away from the palace.
The wretched traitor! That tunnel connects his lands directly to our estates! No one's used it in centuries, but the tunnel opens right under this room! What are we going to do?
I will hold back this army myself if I have to.
You have proven a better friend than I expected. Moff Sarek gave us cartons of thermite explosives. They take time to set up, but they pack a punch. If you take them into the siege tunnel, you can collapse it on Cedric and his army. Seal the access, so they can't threaten us again.
Sounds like a plan.
I don't know what I'd do without you here. There's an entrance to the tunnel nearby.
The storeroom is in the same area. I'll recall my troops to defend the surface, but there's no doubt the real battle will be below. Thank you.
So, you're the Imperial puppet who taught Jorad Thule to bite instead of bark. Does he lick your hand? Fetch your slippers?
Real Alderaanians will never bow to the likes of you.
Yield, and you may keep your title and your lands.
I would sooner see Alderaan blasted into space debris than given over to the Empire. You don't even have the guts to fight this yourself instead of hiding behind a cart and a thermite. If you had a shred of decency, you'd settle this by an honorable duel. You against me.
You against me.
You surprise me, Sith. I heard your kind wouldn't know of honor if they scraped it off their shoe. A duel of skill, then. If you win, I will give my house over to Jorad Thule to use as he will. If I win, you stand aside and let me cleanse Alderaan of this scourge. And tell your Imperial handlers Alderaan lives free or dies! To arms! I concede. You have the better skill. Perhaps it is Alderaan's fate to fall to the Empire. I will tell my people. We must find a way to live through these times.
Show them that sometimes there is more strength in yielding.
I will tell my army to stand down. Thank you for this mercy.
Kalasius just surrendered. My men are returning from the outpost to take them into custody. The Kalasius are acknowledging you as a man of honor. I will tell Moff Serek of your heroism immediately.
Take 10 heads for every one traitor, and they will not rebel again.
The Thals need not fear any further rebellion in their ranks. It would be a waste to keep one of our few Sith here any longer. General Stanul Thal is coordinating our efforts near House Ald. Speak to him if you'd like to take a further role in this conquest.
You have saved my house's dream of ruling our world, and taught me much about what that will mean. I will not forget.
have done. Please select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay. Vehicle pads are currently open for business. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Danil Thule. I was told you want to see me.
Yes, Moff Sarek said you'd be here. We've had an inspection team lost to the Killix for days now, advisors from Droman Kaas. They were inspecting one of our mining sites for lanthanide deposits. But in the middle of their inspection, the entire place was overrun by Killix. We've had no communication for days.
I want the full briefing. Risk assessment, strategic importance, all of it.
Moff Sarek wants the inspection team rescued, and fast. Apparently some of them hold serious rank off-world. And the Killix don't exactly respond to negotiations. They're the native aliens here. Giant bugs with just enough sentience to shoot a blaster. Attacking these Killix would take half our army, but apparently I'm too close to the problem to strategically assess its value.
No Sith would fear a mere bug.
If you help, House Thule will be in your debt, and I will commend you to Moff Sarek, whatever you want me to say. It's not only the inspection team. My daughter is in there too. I don't know if she's alive or dead. If you can find her, find our advisors, free them if they're prisoners. I promise you a reward that will leave me bankrupt.
I will not let these aliens kill your daughter or the advisors.
Thank you. For myself, even more than for my house.
Select an available travel route. Vehicle pads are currently open for business.
Bless you, in the name of the Emperor. Thank you.
Removed those who are not of the nest. Had they stayed, they would have learned the peace of the joining. We will not deny you your prize. But leave now. There has been a song of swarming. We have claimed these mines for the nest.
I'm looking for Stanel Thul's daughter.
Once we were called Daria Thul. Now we are known as New Child of the Ukanuku Nest. We have tasted the gel and scented the egg chamber. We have joined.
So you're a Killik now?
There is peace in the nest. A love that comes of sharing one mind. It is a gift beyond measure. We will never return.
How can you live like this?
How do you live in a world where everyone is a stranger? Where a smile may conceal a knife in the back? Stanel Thul is not my family. He and his kind have brought war to Alderaan in the name of their own power. Here we are safe. Here we are at peace. Here we will stay.
Come with me, or die along with every Killik here. That's your only option.
No, we will never. We are hearing the voice of the Nest. We have decided it is not worth many losses to save one. The Nest has spoken. We will return.
is upon us.
My lady, we have intruder.
Lady Renata, you had a handmaiden who left Alderaan with a Jedi. I seek her family.
What's this nonsense you're spouting? I don't know what you're talking about.
Lady, let me kill this Sith like the last one Duke Kendo sent.
Windred, you don't need my permission to kill an enemy that comes barging through my door. Make it fast.
Violence isn't necessary. I just need information.
All you need is my sword through your neck. Sorry.
This can't be. I'm sorry I ordered him to kill you, Sith. I hope you don't hold it against me. You see, I've been fending off Duke Kendo's advances for some time, and I just assumed you were here for him. If the Duke didn't send you, I'm happy to help. You mentioned a girl that left with the Jedi, right?
Glad to see I have your undivided attention.
You have a very persuasive manner. I was aware of the young handmaiden who left Alderaan with the Jedi Master. But I'm afraid you're mistaken. The girl never served me. I didn't know her.
It seems I've been misinformed.
I'm sure Duke Kendo will double his efforts to help you find what you seek. The Duke congratulates you on your impressive venture into House Alday. I'm here to take the fair lady to him.
No! Don't let him take me to that pig! I do know who the girl worked for. I'll tell you all I can, if only you'll keep me from Duke Kendo.
Don't leave anything out.
All right. I'm going to trust that you'll be honorable. The girl's name is Jaysa Wilsum, and she was a handmaiden of Giselle Organa, of House Organa. She was always by her side. Before the war, Giselle was an aristocrat, like myself. Now she leads the Organan troops against House Olgo.
That's not a lot to go on.
But that's as close as I can get you to Jaysa. Giselle can tell you the rest.
The Duke will know where to find Giselle Organa, and how to reach her. If you let me deliver Lady Renata to him, I'm sure Kendo will happily shed light on the situation for you.
I never intended to keep her safe.
I thought by telling you what I know, you'd show mercy!
Your destiny lies with the Duke, woman. Be nice to him, and maybe he'll treat you well. I meant what I said. I'm sure Kendo can help you find and confront Giselle. You should consult with him on it.
I'll do just that.
I will update Kendo, so he is ready for you. Come, Renata. Time to face your fate.
And a terrible fate it will be.
Thank you. My medics are treating the inspection team for shock, but they seem otherwise unharmed. I wish I could say the same for my daughter. It is clear those monsters have drugged her, brainwashed her. I've heard of this, something in the pheromones that joins their captives to their hive mind.
Turn Thule's troops against the Killix before they can destroy another mind.
You're right. What good is the throne of Alderaan if our world is first overrun by these bugs? They must be driven out! We should slaughter them until nothing but their mounds remain!
General Thule, excuse me. It is urgent I speak with my rescuer at once. I'm Agent Craig Graf, Imperial Intelligence. It was no accident those Killix attacked when they did. The Ulgos pushed them toward that mine.
Are the mines so important?
The mines are nothing. Not until we get production going on Lanthanide. It was a decoy. The push was orchestrated by the Ulgos to distract us from something they're calling Operation Sunshower.
I suggest we make sure their plan doesn't work.
I've heard that term. It's come up a few times in the chatter we're getting from our back door into the Organa networks.
It's a Baradium detonator, a massive explosive. They plan to strike at the heart of Thule lands. The detonator's being transported by Boris Ulgo's elite soldiers. Former Republic Special Forces, with the best weapons they could take, and all the training the Republic gave them.
If Republic soldiers could stand against the Sith, they would not have surrendered at Coruscant.
Just before the Killix arrived, we acquired a data file that I believe to be the launch codes for the detonator.
If you really wish to strike fear into the heart of the Ulgos, get into the camp where they're holding it and set it off prematurely. It won't be the full force of the weapon, but let it be Ulgo that perishes, not Thule.
Select an available travel room.
Ah, you return. I'm beside myself with appreciation for delivering Lady Renata for me. She will prove to be most useful.
Anything for House Thule.
You will forever be cherished here. So, Fimrest tells me the lead was fruitful. Although Lady Renata was not the gold's mistress, she knew who was. Giselle Organa. I should say, General Giselle Organa. Now you have to track her down, which poses a bit of a problem.
Some elaboration is required.
Giselle Organa leads the Organa War against House Ulgo. Her headquarters is protected by an impenetrable force field. No firepower can breach it. The force field allows Giselle and her advisors to be stationed very close to the front and maintain a more hands-on command.
There's got to be a way to penetrate the force field.
Well, that is the task that faces us. Wait! Yes! A force field needs power to maintain itself, yes? So, if we manage to cut the power... And I bet I know exactly where Giselle is getting her juice. If I'm right, you could just walk through the front door.
Sounds very promising.
Almost all the power on Alderaan is supplied by the planetary generator. Giselle must be piggybacking the system to power her force field. Several of my fellows do this to maintain their special security needs. A precise charge at the generator will force fail-safes to fire. The planet won't miss a beat, but ancillary systems like Giselle's force field will have to be manually reset, which could take some time.
And I'd bang my way inside while the force field is down.
Precisely. It is infallible. Fimres, fetch a 7-stroke-7 detonator from my arms cabinet there, and give it to our friend.
As you wish.
The Alderaan power generator is located above the Strait Valley, and it boasts the planet's most advanced security systems. You'll have to fight your way in, set the charge, then fight your way out before the boom. It won't be easy.
Are you trying to make me angry?
Forgive me. Just seeking to prepare you the best I'm able. Once you've detonated the generator, you'll still have to wade through Giselle's surrounding army and invade her headquarters before her force field is reset. I'll be eagerly tracking your progress. Good luck.